Another day in Clash of Clans, another account, let's check it out. What's up guys, we're doing something new today. I think something new is always cool. Have not shown you this account yet. And as you can see, it's engineered. Before you start with the hate comments, listen to me for a second. I'm gonna explain it all. So, as you can see, this account is a Town Hall 10. Has a level 5 king, has pretty much the maxed out barge for a Town Hall 9. And other than that, the troops are pretty much all not upgraded except wizards and the heal spell and rage spell. So, what do I want to do with this? So, you guys may know I'm definitely a big proponent of fair play. As you know, I'm in one of the biggest fair play clans in Germany and I'm all about fair play. But unfortunately, the Supercell matchmaking system makes it just so that you sometimes do not get fair matchups in war, or actually a lot of times. So in this case, once again, you can see, by the way, I'm our number 30. We have 6 Town Hall 10s in war. Those are all legit Town Hall 10s, and the other side has 2 Town Hall 11s. Now, if you play against a clan that can actually play, that's pretty much the end of the war already, because they can triple your top 4 bases and there's nothing you can do about that. However, in farm wars, oftentimes you can win, but now, then, and always again, you see accounts like this one, for example. In the middle of the Town Hall 8s, in the low Town Hall 8s, there's a Town Hall 9 that can have an Archer Queen. And this war is pretty legit, but there's wars that are way worse. For example, in DLZ, a couple of weeks ago, we were facing again in the 30v30. The opponent had 10 more Town Hall 11s or 10 more Grand Wards than we did, but they just don't upgrade defense. So I created this account sort of with the thought of fighting fire with fire, make an engineered account. I'm definitely, by the way, of course, not going to bring it to any serious clan. Going to keep it right here in Plate Gaia, where we do all sorts of fun stuff. And wherever we have a big mismatch, I'm going to use this account to just even up the mismatch. Other than that, you will be able to see that. Let's actually check out our last war and see who I attacked, because I just want to show you. There we go. I attacked number 29 and number 30, which are, of course, the bottom two bases. The war before that, let's check that out. Who did I hit with this account? I hit number 29, number 30, the bottom two bases. So, as you can see, although my troops are already a little bit stronger than my town hall weight is, I'm not using it. Whenever we have a fair war, and there's a fair chance for both sides, I'm not going to use it in the engineered way by attacking higher bases. It's the way it is right now. I wouldn't be able to do that anyways, because take a look at my troops. I cannot 3-star Town Hall 9 or something, but my goal is to make this account a weapon. So the quickest way to achieve that, in my opinion, is through using miners. As you can see, I have not unlocked miners yet. I've just went up to Town Hall 10, and for that reason, I don't have them yet. And that's going to be one of the goals today. I'm just gonna farm for about 2 to 3 hours, just casual, have a little bit of fun with it. I'm probably not gonna upload a 2 or 3 hour video, but sort of the best of a couple of raids. They're probably all gonna be live, are going to be uploaded. And if you did not know about this, it's very, very tough to have an engineered account, actually, because my only defense, as you can see, is this level 1 cannon over here. That means you're getting 3-starred every time. Doesn't matter what army you're getting attacked by. That's not so bad. The bad thing is that people attack you and they don't even use 50% of their army. So as you can see, my defense log 15 minutes ago, I got 3-starred, so technically I should have a 16-hour shield right now, but I don't. And that's because this guy used 43 goblins, and that's not obviously not 50% of his army. So he had 181 goblins at the king, so that makes for 206 army camp space, and he used only 50 of that. So if you get attacked with an army that is lower than 50% of the army that the attacker had with him, you don't get a shield. So for that reason, most of the time I don't get shield, unless, of course, I have defensive clan castle troops, like in this case I have. So if somebody would attack me now, most likely he would have to deploy 50% of his army to destroy my clan castle troops, and then I would get a shield. So what I'm trying to say is that whenever you play an engineered account, You pretty much have to be online all the time. So in case you want to achieve something like today, I want to save up 4 million elixir, ideally 8 million to start both or start two barracks. You pretty much have to be online for the 2 to 3 or 4 hours straight. And that makes it very tough. That's why I see a lot of engineered accounts that then end up dropping a couple of walls or a couple of defenses. I'm not going to do it. I'm going to play it the hard way. As you guys know, I'm a crazy farmer and I love having things a little bit tough sometimes. So yeah, that's what we're going to do. My goal is to start two barracks today. So farm about 8 million elixir and also get the Archer Queen, which of course we don't have yet. So we need about 20,000 more Dark Elixir for that, so hopefully we can achieve that as well. As I said, gonna casually boost for 2 or 3 hours. Don't worry about me, I'm not gonna stare at the screen the entire time. I'm gonna watch a film or something and then just record whenever I find a base to attack. So yeah, that's sort of my goal. Farm a lot of elixir, farm a nice amount of Dark Elixir, drop the queen, drop two or start two barracks hopefully. And yeah, I haven't done Tunnel 10 Barge in quite a while. We're at a very low trophy range, of course, since I always get tripled. So we're gonna have to see if we can make it work. I'm probably gonna put, yeah, I'm definitely going to put music over the farming rates in the background again, so just so it is not that boring for you guys. Probably gonna be a little bit of a longer video, but we are going to see. So yeah, I think this was a very long introduction. I actually didn't mean to talk that long, but I kind of wanted to put it into place just so that you guys can understand what I'm doing and don't have to hate me for it or something, because as I said, I'm all about fair play. I'm always gonna keep it fair play. That's just yeah, my way of doing it. And yeah, so without further ado, let's jump into our first raid, see if we can find a nice amount of loot, and I'll be back whenever I find the first base to attack. Okay guys, I just noticed I've already been talking for about 6 or 7 minutes. I'm just gonna make this for an introduction video for this account. I'm gonna split it right here, make this the first video, make another video where I upload the entire farming. So, and this is gonna be the introduction for Chosen One for my engineered account, so you guys will know what it's all about. And I'm gonna upload the other video right after, so it's probably gonna be out on the same day. And yeah. Then we are actually going to get to the farming, so sorry for that. I did not expect to talk this long about the problem, but I think that engineered is something that has to be addressed. So that's also why I wanted to make videos about this, just to get it out there and get you guys to understand it a little bit better. So yeah, I'm going to cut it here, make this the end of the video. Thank you for watching, and the farming is going to be right after in the next video, which is definitely going to be a lot longer because we are of course going to have a lot of attacks in that.